Another case study. Okay, now this gal drives 350 miles to get to her office. First off, she's got plantar fasciitis. That means the feet are flat. It's straining the bottom of the foot, the fascia on the bottom of the foot. Now, how does a person get flat feet? Because the nerves in the low back are pinched and the intrinsic muscles of the foot are flat. Now, that causes flat feet. But now, let's think about this. If the feet are flat, does that mean her pelvis is going to be moving because she's going to have an abnormal gait? Yes, you got it. Now, she's had an abnormal gait for a while. Does that mean the pelvic structures are unstable? Yes or yes? Okay, you got it. So now I start to ask her. Okay, she comes in with flat feet. Now we know she's got an unstable pelvis. If she's had an unstable pelvis for years, that means the nerves that supply the ovaries, uterus, and bowel are going to be compromised. Guess what she had a few years ago? If you say hysterectomy, you are right. Okay, so now, wait a second, hysterectomy, what's that from? She said it's from abnormal cell growth or some type of cancer. So now, the body has the ability to wipe out cancer, okay? And it does it through secretions of the kidneys and pancreas. Kidneys secrete interferon, the pancreas secretes enzymes. So anybody with cancer anywhere in the body, you got to focus in on the body's immune system or the kidneys and pancreas. Then we go up. And remember, she only came in with flat feet. Okay, so then we go in there, we think kidneys and pancreas. Okay, cool. But now where did that, since that's at the junction of the rib cage and low back, where was another trauma? And I'm asking her. And then she tells me she has a reverse curve in the neck. What happened when she was a teenager? She was riding horses. Beautiful. So now what are we going to do? We look at the neck, take a stress x-ray. I find out we can fix her neck. I find out that there's a major subluxation at the junction that supplies the kidneys and pancreas. We see the pelvic is completely unstable. And guess what's going to happen? She's going to get her pelvic corrected. We're going to restore the intrinsic muscles of the foot. She's going to throw away the foot orthotics. Her immune system is going to be strong, so cancer is not going to negatively affect her ever again. We're going to actually change her diet and give her suggestions. We're going to restore the curve in her neck, reversing the arthritis. This gal is going to have a full, healthy, long life. However, what if instead of her coming here when she's like 50, what if we got to her when she was 16 and fell off the horse at first? What if we were able to correct her curve in her neck before the immune system, before the kidneys, before the cancer, before the pelvic, before the feet got flat? I'm telling you right now, look, pay attention to the kids, pay attention to the first trauma. Okay, look at the real source of this, and we can reverse disease processes years down the road.